This video gives you a lecture on how to create the generating functions from the series provider or to define a generating function from the series provider. See now, a generating function can be used to convert a series into a general function or a general function into a series. Here you can see this is what we mention as series. This is what we mention as a general function. See this, x power k, I think you would be aware of what is this function, summation function. If it is written as this is your lower limit and this is your upper limit. So it starts from 0 to infinity. Okay, so x power k, if I write x power k, it means the value of k varies from 0 so on to infinity. So what will happen? It is nothing but x power k means x power 0 plus x power 1 plus x power 2 plus x power 3 plus so on till infinity. So this x power 0 is written as 1. X power 0 is 1 plus x power 1 is x squared, so on. This is the series. This series can be generalized as this function. Okay, this is the function. This is the generating function and this is the series, right? So same like that, this is the series, this is the generating function, this is your function. So there are three types of generating functions: ordinary generating function, exponential generating function and probability generating function, which we will see in this video. Ordinary generating function format will be of this form, where ak x power k is the general function given. See now, this is the generalized series which is provided. So, wherever you have this AK, it means it is A0, A1, A2. Okay. Wherever you have X power K, it is written as X power 0, 1, 2. So, this variation of K is suitable only for the powers, not for the integers. So, here you can see, if I have A power K is equal to 1, then instead of a power 0, a power a1, a2, whatever it is, you will replace it as just 1. So what will happen? 1 x power 0 plus 1 x power 1 plus 1 x power 2 plus so on. So this will be simplified as 1 into 1, 1 plus 1 x plus x squared plus so on, which is nothing but this function 1 by 1 minus x, like this. Suppose if I have ak is equal to 2, then it is obvious sigma k is equal to 0 to infinity 2 x power k is equal to 2 plus 2 into, instead of this a1, a2, a3, I am writing 2 x power 1 x power 2 plus 2 x power 3 plus so on. 2 is going to be common value, so take it out, x square plus so on, which is nothing but 2 into 1 by 1 minus x as the same term from this expression, which is nothing but 2 into 1 minus x divided by 1 minus x. This is the general function which we will arrive from this series. From this series, you are given with a generating function. From here, you are going to expand the series. From this series, you are going to find the function. Similarly, when you go for exponential generating function, this also implies the same. A n is nothing but the value which is going to be given in the problem. X power n, n, this both n's are nothing but the variation in values. So, you can obviously know that if it is going to be a k is equal to 2, then automatically 2 into a x power 0 divided by 0 factorial plus 2 into x power 1 divided by 1 factorial plus 2 into x power 2 divided by 2 factorial plus so on. You can see only this 2 is additional to this term. Because this is 1, this ak is 1, this ak is 2. Okay. So, after this, you will consolidate this 2 e power x. The next function what we are going to see is your probability generating function. This is the general format of a probability generating function. as we know already, we know how to find the probability of each function. See here, tossing a coin, you have two probabilities, probability of H and probability of T. You can take one to be probability of 0, another to be P1. So this P0 and P1 are nothing but your probabilities. So this is going to be your function. X0, X1, X2 will depend on the value of Xk, and Pk is nothing but your probability values. If you're going to toss a die, you know that you have 6 probabilities, which is nothing but 1 divided by 6 for all. Yes. So if I have another a probability generating function for getting an even number in a die, it means it is 2, 4, 6. These are the possibilities for when you throw a die. These are the possibilities of even probabilities. So probability of 2, probability of 4, probability of 6. This we will take it as probability of P0, P1 and P2. As we know, it is 1 divided by 6, 1 divided by 6, 1 divided by 6. So you will not have these many terms, because here it is tossing a dice. You have 6 probabilities. Here you have only 3 probabilities. So what you will write? 0 plus 1 by 6 x power 1 plus 1 by 6 x power 2. Because you have only 3 probabilities. P0, P1 and P2. Here you have 6 probabilities from P0 to P5. Hope you understand this. If you have any doubts, you can put it on the